Hey guys, what's going on? Matthew or MP Ricks here, and today we're going to be taking a look at set number 71819, the Dragonstone Shrine. This set includes 1,212 pieces. It also includes 6 minifigures and retails for $120 in the US. But with all that said, let's get on to the review. So here's the main build of the Dragonstone Shrine itself. Kind of a weird shape to try and fit on camera, but we're gonna make it work. So just overall, I'm just gonna say first, this is a big mix of stone and tree, as you can see. There's a bunch of moss all over it. We're gonna, just talk big details right now because, I'm not gonna point out every bit of moss everywhere, but it's everywhere basically. So let's take a more deep dive into this. So starting off with the pond right here, we have some fish swimming around in there. We got some stones so you can walk across, as well as this waterfall right here, which goes down into some bubbly water at the bottom, because it's a waterfall, of course. You've got some flowers kind of floating around in there, as well as some water flowing out down here into nothingness, I guess. It just kind of elaborates on it. And then there's a big rock right here, as well as some roots and tree going back that way. Kind of slopes upwards back here. And we're gonna actually take a look at this side first. So we've got, realistically, if you look at the dragon, this would be its tail. So it all goes like this. And then this part is just really there for play. This is mainly a display piece. So this was made more for the adults rather than the children, but there's some good pieces for both sides to enjoy this. Taking some figures here, we'll place Kai right here, as well as grab Roz here and put him right there. I am connecting them by both feet. I don't actually know if maybe they will still fall off. There, yeah, so Kai still falls off. But basically, there is a piece on the other side, which I will show you. But once you place the figures on here, you just shake it until... Here, I'll get you a better angle. You shake it until someone falls off, or both fall off. So, turning it around, you have this. It's pretty well hidden, though, where this can shake, and it just moves it back and forth. I feel that there's too much give. I wish it couldn't move this much because that means I had to go and then push it and then and push it. So, I had to push it extra distance rather than, just pushing it back and forth. And you hear the click there every time rather than just, just the natural sounds. You had to have it hit every time. So... that's something in my mind that's not the best, but realistically, I'm going to be leaving it like this. I mean, other than this review, I have no plans to use this. I had a little fun playing around with it when I built it, but, it's really for display, this set is. And in my opinion, it just looks the best just setting it on a shelf just like this. Taking a look at one of my favorite angles to look at this thing, just this archway and even the one up here, which you can barely see, but this archway just looks so, so nice. You've got some rocks back here that follow this path in the, of course, that goes across the little pond there and inside as well. You got some moss going up. I just love how this angle looks right here. It just looks amazing. And you can even see here, this is one of the dragon's hands right here. So you've got like, The dragon, here's the body, and it's supposed to have like an arm wrapped around the back that sits right here, and he's like holding it like this. And then the other one is, of course, here, which, talking about that right now, you can actually pose that however you would like. Maybe this is a protagonist in your story. Maybe you want this to be able to help the ninja or something, the movable statue or something. But it's primarily in about this position right here. Or at least that's what it shows on the box. So, up to you. But I think that's how I'm going to keep it. Very rocky coming around the back. You got these two big pieces, which honestly kind of break this up for me too much. They break it up too much. There's a reason, and I understand that, and yes, we'll get to that, but it still does break it up. Realistically, I wouldn't have wanted this. At least on the bottom one. I completely understand the top one, but the bottom one, I would have wanted that to be a little different. Moving down from that, we see more tree right here. Just a bunch of brown bricks and slopes and stuff. Here we have some more roots, one right there, and you have a little candle there. Inside of here, we can actually zoom in here. You have a little trophy there, as well as a chi crystal, kind of alluding to Chima being in the merge realms right now, as well as 5 different scrolls here. So very nice. You can remove those, play with them with your figures as you wish. So easy to remove and place back. Just a nice little interior to fit some more figures and some more water flowing off right there. Moving up from here, we actually have a spot for some tea. So, you know, you get Wu in this set, so he can have his tea. And actually, since this is, of course, a review coming out a bit later than when this comes out, we already know that this set is actually the Tournament Temple City, which has already been released. So that's really cool that it kind of correlates. And of course, if you know this set in the show, they correlate even more. Turning it, you have a little bookshelf with some books on top, as well as a little thing with, here, I'll move this. And it's got a dragon with its mouth wide open, roaring at what looks like Wu. I'm gonna try and get it to focus on that. There we go. And he's got a little scroll there, which I would presume is what is in Lloyd's hand, but we'll take a look at that later on. Or maybe that's what's on the wall that we just looked at. A big feature back here is looking at that bookshelf. You can actually press on those books and pop this off. So that's why I understand this one being the big piece, but the bottom one, I don't like it a ton because it kind of takes away from it. It makes it look too built up with big pieces. But what is inside of there is some little torches there and a book with, I don't know what symbol that is, but that's a Ninjargon letter. I'll figure out what that is. And then you've got Wu, or someone there at least, with like a Wu-esque look to them. Focus, there we go. Very nice printing in there, just an interesting thing. Wasn't exactly in the show or anything, so not sure why it's there. Maybe it will show up later, but we'll see. Then you've got just this intricate build with a bunch of slopes and just brown pieces to make up this tree. And we'll actually zoom out and go see what that all looks like. You can see lots of branches going lots of different ways. If I turn this, you can see a ton of pink leaves there, which looks awesome. Looking up at the head, this is a very, very nicely built dragon head. I love how this thing is built. It's got a ton of moss all over it. It's got some horns going up here. Got the eyebrow looking good with the translucent blue eye in there, if you can tell. Then you have a little attached bit of waterfall that flows down into the pond down there. So yeah, I think this is a great build. I don't have a ton more to say about it. I think it's a great display piece. It's a lot smaller than I was expecting, honestly. But you know, it is what it is. And I mean, I still really like this build. It's very nice. I feel like you could take two of them, maybe put them on the sides, like two dragon protectors on a gate or something as you're going in on a boat or whatever. That would be really cool. So we'll see what this thing can do. But yeah, that's really all I have to say about this build. So let's get on to the minifigures, and then I'll tell you my overall thoughts. So here are the first two minifigures included in this set. We have Dragon's Rising Kai and Dragon's Rising Nia. Now, these are their original suits from Dragon's Rising. These are the first ones they used. And I'm kind of sad we didn't get, like, Climber Ninja here. Maybe we could have gotten, like, a Climber Nia or even a Climber Lloyd in here. Which, I'm not mad that we got the other Lloyd, but, you know, someone other than these two that we got before. Nia's not the worst because she wasn't the most accessible. Her cheapest was a 4 plus set at $35, or not a 4 plus set at $95. So I'm still glad to get her. And then they do include their hair pieces with headbands on them, which I'm probably just going to put in a bucket and replace them for some hood attachments there. So, especially Nia, though, because, I mean, this is a really good figure. I love this Nia figure. I just don't like the hair on it. And then Kai is a fairly common minifigure. I have three of the polybag that includes this full figure. Yeah, of course, with the full mask, too. But, you know, looking a little deeper, I love that Kai used the dark red and the black belt here. That looked really good. I love that they have their circular symbols there. And then Nia's with the blue, with the azure, and there goes her weapon. And the gunmetal gray looks sick. This is an awesome figure. And then the dark red belt, too. I'm telling you, Nia's a great figure. And then they include some weapons. Nia's has a dragon hilt and a little sai on it. And then Kai's is a little machete there. So not too much to say about these guys, but they're still good inclusions. I'm glad we still got two minifigures rather than just the four other ones. But definitely the least exciting in this set. So let's get on to the next two. So here are the next two minifigures included in this set. We have Master Lloyd and we have Lord Roz. Now, getting their accessories out of the way, Lloyd here has his regular sword, but on a spear, which is actually a really cool build. I'm glad this was included. It's a nice different build for him. And then Roz, for his weapon, he has this little hammer axe thing, which is cool. I don't think this is actually not the one he used in the show. So nothing super special there. And then Lloyd has this page that I mentioned before. Not exactly sure what it is. I'm going to try and translate that. So this sticker here actually says invite, which, I mean, it's cool to have a physical invite to the Tournament of Sources. But, you know, this, of course, if you've seen the show, isn't exactly how they gave out the invites. So interesting, but not exactly accurate. The Lloyd figure I have talked about before, which is a great figure. He does include armor, which he never actually wore in the show. And then he's got two little banners with L on it, as well as a chain that looks like it should hold a cape, but he never wore one. He's got his headband hairpiece, but actually molded in bright green instead of regular green to match his newer appearance. All white robes, which looks awesome. He's got dark green, you know, dragon scale kind of design going down with some dark orange straps around his legs. Around back, you can see his green source dragon symbol there surrounded by gold, which looks very awesome. I love this figure. It's a great one. He's got tan underneath. Love all the detail on this figure. It is a great one. Roz is also a great figure. Gosh, I wish this guy had arm printing. That would have been amazing. This is the only one without arm printing we've gotten so far. And actually, if you've seen the show, of course, he shows up with red on him. He changes to red. So I'm actually going to order a head with red on it and swap him out, as well as the hands and everything. So removing this so we can see closer, that is just the same head as well as the original stone armor piece there. And then you have kind of this blue and silver going all throughout. When you get the light just right, the silver makes it look amazing. It lights up just the perfect spots, and this guy looks awesome. He's got purple robes going down, as well as some just blue spikes all over. This guy looks great. He's got the moon on the back. I love this figure. Although he doesn't have arm printing, I still think I like him better than the original Roz. So yeah, I just like his color scheme better. It fits him more. So yeah, that's all I have to say about these two. Great minifigures, great inclusions. They're not exclusive, but they are still great to get here. So let's go on to the two exclusive minifigures. So here are the next two minifigures included in the set. We have Master Wu and Euphrasia. starting off with Master Wu's little accessory here. He has a new staff with dragon hilts. So here are the next two minifigures included in this set. We have Master Wu and we have Euphrasia. Starting off with Master Wu's accessory here. He has a new staff with dragon hilts on either side. Good looking staff. I'm glad it was included here. Great to get more of those dragon hilt pieces. Those are amazing pieces. And then Euphrasia's staff here. Must be some sort of wind staff or something. I don't believe it was in the show, so that's cool. And then Euphrasia actually has this hairpiece, which you can swap out for a hood here. Which, before this, we had only seen her with the hood on. And then after this, we did actually see her with the hair. So, personally, I don't know what I prefer. And there goes the hood. But, you know, either way works. I like it. Looking at Wu first here, we can actually remove all this. Same head we've been getting, or I guess core, rather, we got from core. So there we go. We got some tan robes looking pretty good. Looks like maybe he has his core robes under this. Some golden detailing on his legs. Awesome that he's got just dark tan all over. He doesn't really wear dark tan often, so this is kind of a special figure. It's a lot different than what we've seen before. And honestly, I don't remember seeing this one in the show. I'm pretty sure the one that showed up in this scene, or in this scene that we saw with him at the Dragonstone Shrine, pretty sure he was just wearing his core outfit. So, you know, that's kind of cool. But the biggest thing about this figure is, I don't know what suit line to put him with. Should I put him with the original Dragon's Rising suits, because they're included in this set? Or maybe I should put him with the climber suits because that's the time that he showed up at the Dragonstone Shrine. So let me know in the comments if you guys have any, you know, thoughts on where it should be included on my minifigure stand, what suit line it should be considered with. Because he was also, like, he was released alongside both mech suit and climber suits. So I'm honestly not sure. I was kidding when I said the original Dragon's Rising suits. He's not going to be there. Core belongs there. I'm going to get an extra for that. But where should I put this guy? And then Euphrasia actually has this very nice blue design. Her elemental kind of, you know, master robes. She's got this nice, nice sky blue color with some regular blue underneath. As well as, I guess, the wind symbol that is not Moro's symbol. I like how well this blue on her legs actually matches her torso. I don't know why, I just wasn't expecting it. And it just does. Which, I don't know why I wasn't expecting it, because it's on white, so it should work. But it just looks really good. It does work really well. Kind of gets broken when you turn her, but still very nice. I like all the detail on the back. Sad that it's just a regular city face. I'm so sad about that. When we get a normal Euphrasia face, I'm going to put it on this figure because that's just kind of sad to me. So great two amazing figures to be included. I'm glad they're here. So let's get on to my overall thoughts on this set. So what are my overall thoughts on this set? Personally, I think this set has a decent minifigure selection. It's not bad. I mean, I would have liked other suits, but still, it's not bad for what it is. This really doesn't fit in with the other ones specifically, so I think it's not bad. I like the minifigure selection. I like all the posability with minifigures. I like that it's just a big display piece for collectors. I love getting these exclusive minifigures in this set. So I would totally recommend picking up this set. When I got this, it was $80 at Costco, which is an amazing deal. I mean, that's $40 off. This is a great set for that much off. So yeah, those are just my thoughts. Let me know what you guys think down below in the comments. Let me know which set you want me to review next, and I guess I'll see you in the next one. Bye.